Hey everyone, Patrick CK here, and this is episode 2 of 3D Printing with the Monoprice Maker Select V2. Last time I showed you how to assemble the printer and then printed a random model that came pre-installed. Since then, I did get a replacement printer that didn't have a broken screen. I assembled it and printed another random model. This time it turned out to be a butterfly. In this episode, I'll be going through creating and printing the first of my own 3D models. Now, if you want to do something more than print the models included with your kit, you're going to need to get into using computer-assisted design programs. Again, one of the reasons I bought the Maker Select is that it doesn't have proprietary design and encoding software. This means you can use pretty much any 3D CAD program that allows you to save into the format that the printer can read, which in this case is GCode. I was really looking forward to this specific feature because it means I could possibly use Google SketchUp to create my models. If you're not familiar with Google SketchUp, I would definitely check it out. It is an amazing CAD program that is incredibly easy to learn and allows you to create pretty much anything your imagination can come up with. Even if you don't have a 3D printer, but are interested in making 3D models, I wouldn't hesitate to start playing around with it. SketchUp was released back in August of 2000, and that's pretty much how long I've been using it. Of course, until now, I would just make completely random things like spaceships, or floor plans, satellites, furniture, etc. But now it's time to make these models come to life. Before I start on this project, I wanted to make sure I could create and export models in the right format. Unfortunately, the basic free version of SketchUp does not do this. Luckily, thanks to the amazing SketchUp community, there is an extension that will allow you to export models as STL files. I know this isn't G-code, but it's a step in the right direction. We'll get to the G-code part in a second. It's extremely easy to install the extension. Simply go to the link in the description and download the RBZ file. In SketchUp 2017, go to the Window menu and select Extension Manager. When the new window pops up, click on the button at the bottom that says Install Extension and simply select the RBZ file you downloaded earlier. That's it! The extension is installed. It may give you a warning saying the extension is unsigned, but you can ignore it. These steps are different for older versions of SketchUp, so I would highly recommend updating. Now, go ahead and create the new model. Since I'm new to the world of 3D printing, I wanted to keep it simple, but also wanted to do some testing to see the limitations of the printer. So I went with a design like this. A couple of things I wanted to test was how well the Maker Select would create this large swooping curve, and how defined the lettering would come out in the final product. As you can see, some of the letters are raised, and others are recessed. I thought this would give the final product an interesting shadow effect under certain lighting. Make sure to clean up any faces or stray lines that are not needed to make sure the final format is easy to interpret for the next step. The overall dimensions of this model are 3/4 inch in width, 3.5 inches long, and 1.5 inches tall. Using inches was an oversight that will come back to mildly annoy me. With the model done in SketchUp, we first save it to the native SKP file format for future edits. Then, to use the extension we installed earlier, simply go to the Tools menu and select Export to DSF or STL. In the first dialog box, you can tell it to save the entire model. Hopefully, you got rid of any stray elements in the work area. Then, since I used inches, I exported in inches. In the next window, select STL from the drop-down menu. And finally, save it to wherever directory is good for you. So now we have a STL file, which basically represents all the faces of the model we just made. Now it's time to make that STL into a G-code file that the Maker Select can use. This step is really simple. We need to download and install a program called Cura. There are plenty of other programs that can accomplish the same job, but since it was recommended by Monoprice, and it's really easy to use, not to mention free, it's a no-brainer. To get Cura, you can use the link in the description or simply Google Cura CAD program, which will bring up the Ultimaker website, the creators of Cura. After you download, install, and open it for the first time, Cura will ask you what printer you're using. Since the Maker Select is not listed, just choose the Prusa i3, which is a printer that the Maker Select is based off of. The nozzle width, bed and extruder temperatures, print speed, etc. are all the same. The only difference is the work area. The Maker Select's print area is a little bigger, another selling point, and I haven't figured out how to change this since the printer settings are fixed. It's not a problem in this case because the model is not that large. To import the model, just select the open file icon in the top left and find your STL file. This is where using inches to build the model came back to annoy me. The default measurements of Cura are in millimeters. So the model came in at 3/4 of a millimeter in width, which is really tiny. I thought it didn't even import until I zoomed all the way in. I haven't figured out how to change the default measurements yet. If you know how, please leave a comment and thanks. This wasn't as big a deal since all I had to do was use the scale tool to enlarge the model so that it would be 19.05 millimeters in width, which is equal to 3/4 of an inch. Then I centered it in the work area, and that's pretty much it. Of course, you can mess around with all the settings of the model and printer, but for this test, I just left everything at default, with a light infill and normal quality. I really like how Cura tells you how long it will take to print the model and how much filament it will use. For my model, a little over an hour and a half to print, and 3.5 meters or 11.7 feet of filament. Here are the last two steps. Save it as a Cura project locally, then click on the Save to File button in the bottom right and select the GCode extension if it's not already selected, and save it with an easily recognizable name. If you have the micro SD card plugged into your computer, save it to the home directory, otherwise just copy it over when you're ready. Now it's time to print this thing. Preheat the printer, mount the SD card, select the file to print, and sit back and watch the magic. Now, to be honest, I had no idea how this would turn out. I wasn't sure if the printer settings would be 100%, or if having the model be interpreted by two different CAD programs using three different file extensions would cause any issues. At this point, I couldn't do anything but wait. I'll speed it up for you. Of course, my old GoPro died on me twice. It's definitely taking shape, and I like what I'm seeing. Here's the final product, and I'm very happy with it. Of course, it's my first model, and it didn't go completely awry, so I'm excited either way. A couple of things I did notice is that at the lower part of the curve, where the gradient is shallow, you can see the step pattern. But I actually don't mind this, because it does smooth out further up the curve, and a little sanding will smooth it out. The more noticeable thing is that the letter K is not as recessed as it was modeled. I'm not sure if I could have done something different in the model to make this part turn out better, or if it's a limitation in the level of detail the printer can create. More testing is in order for sure. Well, that's it for episode 2. I'm really excited to keep exploring the world of 3D printing, and to bring all of you along with me. I'll be doing some more testing over the next couple weeks. Next time I'll work on something more practical that I can use around the house or at work. This has been Patrick CK. Like and share if you enjoyed this content. Subscribe to get more videos when they come out, and hope to see you all next time. Thanks everyone.